Last video, I showed you how to create a beginner ESPHome sensor using our special case. So, in this video, we will be taking it to the next level by adding a light sensor and a temperature, humidity, and pressure sensor to it. And if you're ready, let's go! To get this working, we are going to need the sensor from our last video. And a light sensor, a temperature, humidity, and pressure sensor. To make things easier, this time we are going to need male-to-male Dupont cables. And also male-to-female ones. I'll show you how to use them later on the video. And to secure the cables, we are going to use a Termoretractil Heat Shrink tube. Now, for this project, I had to make some adjustments to the case. I added two bigger cutouts to the case to allow the sensors to capture more information from their environment. You can get the new version on printables, or you can order it from our sponsor, PCBWay. They are not just any PCB manufacturer. They are the one-stop online manufacturer with 24/7 customer service. PCBWay provides lightning-fast PCB fabrication and assembly, along with offerings in 3D printing and CNC machining. They provide the easiest way to make your smart home projects come to life. Whether you're a student tinkering in your garage or a seasoned engineer working on the next big thing, PCBWay has your back. Thank you, PCBWay, for sponsoring this video. If you already have the case from last week, you can use some wire cutters to make a hole right here. Like this. That way you don't have to print the case all over again. Now, to wire it up, we are going to use this table. And as you might notice, both sensors share pins on the board. Now, to achieve this, we are going to use the Dupont cables. Let me show you how. Now, for this, we are only going to need 4. And if you can, to make things easier, try to grab one with the same color. Now, what we are going to do is remove this plastic cap as the last time. We are going to use a toothpick. Once you're finished, we are going to do the same with one side of the male-to-male Dupont cables. Now, what we are going to do is we are going to insert inside of this space right here the tip of the other Dupont cable. So just grab the same color and just push it inside. This is going to create all the contact that we need and is going to allow us to use two sensors without too much hassle. Now, to secure this, we are going to use the thermoretractile tube. So just grab one piece, measure the size. Now we are going to just put it here, be sure that the placement is right, and then just use a lighter and gently. And that's it. Now let's continue with the rest. Now we're going to solder this end to the light sensor and this one to the temperature, humidity, and pressure sensor. And once we're finished, we are going to connect this to the ESP32 board. Now let's get on with it. Okay, first, for the light sensor, we are going to use all the pins except the last one. So that is VCC, GND, SCL, and SDA. So just connect the cables in order. Now just grab the solder iron, get the pin hot, and then apply some soldering wire. You don't want a lot, just enough to grab the pin. Then move on to the next one. Remember, get it hot first, and then apply a little bit of soldering wire. And that's it. Now we are just going to cut the tips. And then proceed with the humidity, temperature, and pressure sensor. This time, we do need to pay attention to the order. 3 volts is going to be VDD, then SDA, then ground, that is the orange cable in my case, and to finish SCL. Double check with the light sensor to be sure, and then we just need to solder it. And that's it. Now, we just need to cut the tips. And now we just need to connect this end to the ESP32 board. Let me clean this a little bit. Okay, so now we are going to assemble our sensor. For this, let's start with 3.3 volts. Just connect this to the board, then ground. Then we are going to connect SEL to D22. And then SDA to D21. And that's it. Now, before putting it on our case, we need to arrange the cables. So first, let's deal with the present sensor part. This is going to take this place inside the case. Then these cables we are going to bend like this. The light sensor is going to go on the bottom left part of the case. Remember to bend the connected pins a little bit inwards. And then we're going to grab this other cable, bend it like this, and bend this part like this. I know that right now it looks a little bit messy, and it actually is, but it's easier to do it before putting everything on the case. And now just put it inside the case. First the present sensor, then the antenna, then the light sensor, and at the end the temperature sensor. Then just arrange this side of the cable. Check that everything is in place, and then just press it together. And that's it. And now we just need to flash it. For this, go back to my website, and here go to ESPHome Firmware. Now just connect the sensor to the computer. Select the version of the firmware that you want to use. Then select the controller. Click on connect. Here, click on install. And again, install. Now, just press the boot button on the device until it starts installing. And that's it. Now, click on next. Here, we are going to connect it to our Wi-Fi network. And then click connect. Now click on add to home assistant. Click on open link. And here click OK. Select the sensor. And click submit. And finish. Now click on ESPHome. Click on one device. And if you scroll down, you can find the values here for humidity, temperature, pressure, and illuminance. And that's it. And for simple calibration, I added some helpers, so we can adjust the humidity, illuminance, pressure, and temperature values. On my testing, the temperature and humidity values are affected by the heat generated by the present sensor, but they follow a linear path. So what we can do is use the offset to adjust the value. For example, here. At 5 p.m. the reported value was 31.3. So just open the calculator, enter 31.3, and then just grab the right value from our calibrated temperature sensor. That will be 27.96. And we have a difference of 3.3. So now go to your settings, look for temperature offset, and here we are going to enter -3.3. And that's it. This will adjust the values from your temperature sensor. And you can repeat the process for humidity, pressure, and illuminance. On my testing, I didn't need the illuminance offset, but it's there if you need it. And that's it. And if you want access to the YAML file to use it on your own project, you can buy it on our coffee shop, or you can get free access to it during the first week by becoming a member. If you see this badge, you are still on time. Just make sure to log on our website with your member account, and then just click on the lock icon. Once you unlock it, it will remain available on our website as long as you're a member. And if you didn't get it on time, you have 25% discount on our coffee shop. If you like my work, please consider becoming a member on Ko-fi or Patreon. Like all these amazing people, this is my way of saying thank you so much for all your support. It really means the world to me. And don't forget to subscribe for more content like this. I'll see you on the next video. Bye!